Hello and welcome to another video. If you're following my channel now for a longer time already, you might have noticed that I really enjoy to compare gaming peripherals, and today we're going to compare the Apex Pro Tkl with the Ana Pro 2. And don't be worried, I'm none of those cringe YouTubers who just say, yeah, the Apex Pro is faster, so therefore it's better. I'm going to point out the benefits of both keyboards and my overall opinion for who this keyboard might be interesting as a future pickup. So firstly, let's start with the build quality and the features. The Apex Pro does only come in two varieties, the full-sized Apex Pro and the 80% Apex Pro Tkl. It features Steelseries brand new Linear Omnipoint Switches, which are 25% faster than a common mechanical switch, which makes this keyboard insanely fast. And for those people who ask themselves, is it really that much noticeable? Yes, yes it is. Straight up from the first time using this, you notice how fast this keyboard is. The switches have an actuation point of 0.4 mm, which is mind-blowing considering that even speed silver switches have a travel distance of 1.2 mm. Now, when it comes down to the build quality, the keyboard just feels really solid and there is no keyboard flexing or bending. But to be honest, at such a premium price of $220, depending on where you live, I didn't expect there any to be. But is the build quality really that much better that it's worth it paying $160 more than for a regular mechanical keyboard? No, probably not. But as Steelseries mentioned, this is really the highest quality standard you can get from a pre-build. After the comparison, I'm going to do a sound test, or you can simply click on the timestamps down in the description, and now let's move on with the Ana Pro 2. And since my entire setup was inspired by none other than the only Turner Tenny Tfue, my Ana Pro 2 does come with tactile Gateron Brown switches. And since there is no point in comparing linear with tactile switches, we're just going to stick to the build quality and features of this keyboard. Other than the Apex Pro, the Ana Pro 2 is a 60% keyboard, which makes it significantly smaller than even the Tkl version of the Apex. 60% layouts are the most customizable layouts in the keyboard industry, since every single keycap set meant for MX or Gateron or similar switches will fit 100%. Through the smaller form factor, it obviously takes less space on your desk as well, which might benefit towards some people. Next on, the Ana Pro 2 actually does come with Bluetooth straight out of the box, while the Apex Pro only can offer USB-C connection. Of course, we have to remember that the Apex Pro is straightly meant as a gaming keyboard, therefore no one who takes competitive gaming serious should rely on Bluetooth. The overall build quality is really solid, there's a little bit of keyboard bending, but nothing too crazy here. The keycap stabilizers are also one of the best on the market, which makes this an insane bang for your buck. Especially on sale, this masterpiece can be picked up for under $17, which is a great deal without any regrets. Now I'm going to give you guys a small sound comparison, and then we continue with my overall conclusion. So now my final conclusion. what do I think about for who this keyboard might be an option? Firstly, you need a full-on gaming setup with a 240Hz monitor and a gaming PC which can run all your games at 240fps consistently. The reduced input delay throughout the purchase of the fastest keyboard on the market now is nowhere near as big as the extra delay through a low refresh rate monitor. Then, as next thought, ask yourself, are we really at such a high level of skill where your movement and overall performance will really benefit from a 25% faster keyboard? Just keep in mind, the best tools don't make you automatically a better player, but in the right hands, they can help a lot. If you only want this keyboard for its aesthetics and fancy display, get the Apex 7, which is a fantastic keyboard as well and has come with a huge variety of switches to choose from. There are just so many better ways to invest $220 into a gaming setup, even if you've got the extra cash around. For $220, you could buy a cheap 144Hz monitor and pick up a used Razer Huntsman keyboard with optical switches from their newest lineup, which is still insanely fast. Please just make sure to think about if spending $220 just for a keyboard is really what you need. As you might have noticed, this review is more towards people who still don't know if they should purchase this keyboard or not. And I've been there as well. And for a long time, I thought about, is it really worth it for me to get this keyboard, especially at such a high price? And in the end, I can say, yeah, it was worth it. I'm quite happy since this is really the best keyboard I've ever owned. But yeah, considering its price, it still hurts a little bit. And with that said, guys, make sure to rate this video. Since these reviews do take a lot of time to make, make sure to sub, it would help me a lot, and feel free to ask me any questions about those keyboards down in the comment section of this video. I try to answer as many as possible. Have a wonderful day, and until next time, peace.